فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
So here we're going to go into another point which he rahimahullah is mentioning. Before we move on, I'm going to mention the views of who said which chain of narration is almost authentic. Zuhri an Salim an Abihi, this is narrated that Ishaq ibn Rahuyata and Ahmed ibn Hanbal said that this is the most authentic chain of narration. They said that this is the most authentic. They said that if Ibn Shihab al-Zuhri narrates from who? Salim, and Salim narrates from his father. His father is who? Abdullah ibn Umar. Then they said this is the most authentic chain of narration. This is the view of Ishaq ibn Rahuyata and Ahmed ibn Hanbal. The next one is if Muhammad ibn Sirin narrates from Abidata Salamani, who narrates from Ali ibn Abi Talib, they said that this view is taken by Ali ibn Madini and Fallas. They said that this is the most authentic chain of narration. The third one, which is if A'mash narrates from Ibrahim al-Nakha'i, and Ibrahim al-Nakha'i narrates from Alqamah, and Alqamah narrates from Abdullahi. Now, Abdullahi here is who? Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Imam Yahya ibn Ma'in said this is the most authentic chain of narration. Yahya ibn Ma'in said that this is the most authentic chain of narration. The fourth one is Zuhri narrates from Ali ibn al-Husayn an Abihi, and Husayn ibn Ali ibn Abi Talib, who narrates from Ali ibn Abi Talib, and this is the view taken by Abu Bakr ibn Abi Shaybah, the great Imam that wrote the Musannaf, rahimahullah. Bukhari rahimahullah, he chose the fifth one, which is if Malik narrates from Nafi', and Nafi' narrates from who? Abdullah ibn Umar. Imam al-Bukhari said this is the most authentic chain of narration. All of those views are good. Huh? Now some even went to another point where they said, no, what? It's better that we say, some said, no, it's better that we say the most authentic chain of narration of Abu Bakr is this, the most authentic chain of narration of Umar is this, the most authentic chain of narration of Fulan is this, or to say the most authentic chain of narration of this people, of this land is this. I mean, there's views and views. I advise you, if you want to see all of these chains of narrations, go to the Al-Ba'ith al-Hadith, Iqtisar al-Ulum al-Hadith by Ahmed Shakir. Ahmed Shakir, and he brings it on the Ta'liqat, the Sharah he done on the Iqtisar al-Ulum al-Hadith by Ibn Kathir. Ibn Hajar, rahimahullah, after that point, he's swiftly moving on to another point, which is the most authentic book. The most authentic book, or the most authentic books. He's going to go into in the order of the most authentic books. That's what he's going to go into. وَمِن ثَمَّ after what he mentioned, meaning that the hadith in its levels, they're not the same in authenticity. We just saw. Because they have أَصَحُ الْأَسَانِيدَ and whatnot. حافظ رحمه الله, he said, وَمِن ثَمَّ after what was mentioned, قُدِّمَ صَحِيحُ الْبُخَارِي ثُمَّ مُسْلِمُ ثُمَّ شَرْطُهُمَا. The first one he said that is given presidency and given put forward is Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala. Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah. Bukhari's book is what? He is awwalu man sanafa fi sahih al-mujarrad. Bukhari was the first person. Brothers, pay attention. Nobody came before Imam al-Bukhari who conditioned authenticity for his book. He was the first to do that. First. Before him, sahih was written. But no one conditioned authenticity. Bukhari was the first to say, my book, everything in it is going to be authentic. First, أول من قال, the first person who said, or the first person who authored in a book, which is purely and all of it to be sahih. He's the first one who did it. And then after him came his student, Al-Imam Muslim ibn al-Hajjaj, rahimahullah. I want to ask you guys a question now. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i, rahimahullah, he said, ما على ظهر الأرض. Pay attention. Shafi'i said, on the face of this world today, there is no book after the book of Allah, أَصَحُّ مِنْ كِتَابِ مَالِكٍ, more authentic than the book of Imam Malik, the Muwatta. Hey, how do we explain that? Shafi'i is saying that the most authentic book after the Qur'an is the Muwatta Imam Malik. نعم. Shafi'i was before Imam al-Bukhari and it was qabla wujud al-sahihain. Shafi'i, remember this, always remember this. The four a'immatul arba'a were before the six books of hadith. Abu Hanif was before Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim and Dawud al-Midhi ibn Majah. So was Imam Malik. So was Imam al-Shafi'i. And so was Imam Ahmad. They were all before them. Pay attention. So Shafi'i was talking about the book that was present prior to Bukhari's book coming out. He didn't see it. كَانَ قَبْلَ وُجُودُ الصَّحِيحَيْنِ. Ibn al-Salah pointed that out in his kitab, Ulum al-Hadith. So the ulama brothers are of the view that Bukhari's book, are you with me? Bukhari's book is the most authentic book. And it has the most benefit. And that his book, it took precedence in authenticity over every book that came after it. And then after comes his student, a Muslim ibn al-Hajjaj. Until Imam al-Bukhari رحمه الله دارقطني he said لولا البخاري لما راح مسلم ولا جاء. If it was not for Bukhari, Muslim would not have come, nor he would have left. If it wasn't for Bukhari, Muslim would not have been in the equation, nor would he have left the equation. He would have been nothing. Meaning in the sense Bukhari taught him. That means a benefit in general. That's something mentioned by Dara-Qutni. That's a general praise. But when we come to in terms of specifying why Bukhari's book is greater, the reason that Bukhari's kitab is more greater than the book of Imam Muslim is, it goes back to two things. Bukhari's kitab is better in terms of authentic, the chain of narration being connected, the connection of the chain, that's the first one. And it's also greater than Muslim in the angle of the narrators are reliable. The reliability of the narrators. From those two angles, Bukhari's kitab is better. And this is the evidence to show you. Bukhari, rahimahullah, the men in which he was alone in bringing, that Muslim did not bring in his book. Pay attention. The men that you find, there are repetitive men they use. Both of them. But the men that Bukhari was alone, that Muslim did not bring is 435 men. 435 men Bukhari had alone. Muslim didn't have these 435 men. From those 435 men, which you will find in Bukhari alone, but you won't find in Muslim, those who have been criticized from those 435 criticized are 80 of them only. From those 435, those which have been criticized from those 435 is only 80. 80 have been criticized. What about the narrators that Muslim narrated in his Sahih that you won't find in what? That you will not find in Bukhari is 620. 620. The narrators that have been criticized from those 620 is 160. So who has a stronger men? Bukhari does. Because the criticism that has been put to his men is less in number. 160. The second one is, that Bukhari, the men in which he's alone in, who were criticized, he did not bring in his Sahih many times. Does that make sense? Those men in which Bukhari was held against, he didn't use them in his book in many occasions. Where Muslim brings them a bit more than Bukhari normally does. So for that reason, Bukhari's authenticity is stronger. The third one is, the men that were spoken against Bukhari for, the men in which his Sahih was spoken against him for, the majority of them are his teachers. The majority of those 100, those 80 are his teachers. So we will say that the man is more aware of his teacher than you are. The man is more aware, the individual knows his teachers better than you do. Whereas Muslim is the opposite. The people in which he narrated from, it is those he was a contemporary or he lived at the same time as. The fourth one is, the majority of the people that Bukhari was held against for, or the men that was criticized from the 80 of his, he brings their narration not to use it as an evidence in and within itself, but to use it as a backup for other narrations, as a shawahid. Are you with me? For it to witness for other narrations. Opposite to Muslim. Muslim brings it in his usul, in the asal of his kitab. Again, Bukhari is better than that angle. The fifth reason why Bukhari's hadith, so that was all that had to do with what? The adal of the ruwat. We finished that. The fifth one is now, are you with me? Bukhari rahimahullah, the matters pertaining to his connection of the chain of narration, ma yata'allaqu bi ittisal sanad, that which pertains to the chain of narration being connected for Imam al-Bukhari. If you look at the methodology of Imam al-Bukhari and you look at the methodology of Imam Muslim, you will find that their methodology is different. Let's take Muslim for instance first. His methodology was what? His methodology is, if the narration consists in it, it has an'ana in it. He said that it has the rolling of it being connected. If the people who are narrated from each other and lived at the same time, he said that's enough for me. And it was possible for them to meet each other. Whereas Bukhari, he said no, that's not sufficient. He said, I need an additional condition, which is these people have to have met each other, even if it's once. That is an additional condition I require. There has to be ijtima'uhuma walaw marra. There has to be them meeting each other, even if it's one. So Bukhari, what did he negate? Mujarrad al-mu'asara. Just the fact that they lived at the same time, Bukhari wasn't sufficed with that. So who's better in terms of chain now? Bukhari is better. And then you come back to the kalam of who? Iraqi rahimahullah, where he said, rahimahullah, أول من صنف في الصحيح محمد وخص بالترجيح. The first person who authenticated an authentic book is Muhammad. Meaning who? Muhammad ibn Ismail al-Bukhari, Imam al-Bukhari. وخص. And he's specific. Huh? He's specific to have what? He's specific, rahimahullah ta'ala, in authenticity. وَمُسْلِمٌ بَعْدُ وَبَعْضُ غَرْبِ مَعْ أَبِي عَلِيٍّ فَضَّلُوا ذَلَوْ نَفَعْ. And Muslim is after Bukhari in authenticity. Even that though we find some of the ulama of Maghrib, they gave precedence to Muslim over Bukhari. The scholars have replied back to why the reason is that. Is replied. Like مثلاً Abu Ali al-Naysaburi. Abu Ali al-Naysaburi. He gave presidency to which book? He gave presidency to Muslim over what? Like Ibn Hazm, مثلاً. He gave presidency to Muslim over what? Bukhari. The scholars, they replied to that. Do you know what they said? They said, لَقَدْ تَشَاجَرَ قَوْمٍ فِي الْبُخَارِيِّ وَمُسْلِمٌ فَقَالُوا أَيُّذَيْنِ تَقَدَّمُوا لَقَدْ فَاقَ الْبُخَارِيُّ صِحَّةً كَمَا فَاقَ الْمُسْلِمُ صِنَاعَةً. Bukhari passed Muslim in authenticity. But you know what Muslim passed Bukhari in? In the way Muslim wrote his book. Muslim, the way he organized his book is far greater than the way Bukhari organized his book. Why is that? Bukhari, because he was chaptering, and Muslim did not chapter his book. And Muslim was not looking after chaptering. Because the person who done the chaptering of Imam al-Muslim's book, some say is Nawawi, and some say no, it's not only Nawawi, Abu al-Abbas al-Qurtubi, who done the sharah, which is al-Mudhib lima al what's it called? Al-Mudhib lima ashkala fi sahih Muslim? I think so. Abu al-Abbas al-Qurtubi, who also done the sharah of Nawawi, sahih Muslim, they all came together and what did they do? They chaptered Muslim for him. Bukhari, because he was looking after chaptering, pay attention. Because Bukhari was looking after chaptering, what does he do? He cuts up the hadith, he places it in different places. The hadith which should have been in its long, lengthy point, he will take part out of it, put it in that chaptering. He's looking after chaptering. And so what would that do to the hadith? It will break up the hadith. And the hadith will be placed in different places. Huh? And this will cause the student of knowledge not to have the salis. The way he can find the lengthy of the hadith. When Muslim will bring the chain of narration, the hadith in its totality. Totality. So you find a hadith as a whole in Muslim. Bukhari, no. The hadith is cut from your part, and you find another part of it segment in another place, or he might bring the same hadith under different chapters. The way he organized it, scholars, they said, na'am. The Hafiz, rahimahullah, we took previously in our previous class, when he was talking about that Muslim was put before Bukhari. Sorry, Muslim was put before Bukhari in terms of as-sana'ah. Sana'ah hadithiyah, the way the Muslim wrote his book. And Bukhari was put before Muslim in terms of authenticity. We spoke about that issue. And that the qawl of Abi Ali and Naysaburi, who had said, مَا تَحْتَ أَدِيمُ السَّمَاءِ, there is nothing under the sky, كِتَابٌ أَصَحُ مِنْ كِتَابِ مُسْلِمٍ, a book that's more authentic than the book of Imam Muslim. Abu Ali Naysaburi's view on that issue, is not referring to al-asahiyyah. It's not going back to the authentication of the book, and which one is more authentic. But what he's referring to, on the other hand, is he's referring to that the book is what? That the Muslim's book is better in terms of sard. Because if you go back to Muslim, after Imam Muslim, rahimahullah, you come from the muqaddimah. After the introduction, Muslim's book is all sardul ahadith. All the hadith are just long, and it goes on like that. So memorization, the way it's organized, Muslim is better. Whereas Bukhari, rahimahullah, authenticity, we spoke about it. We spoke about Bukhari's men is better. And we also spoke about the shart of Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, in regards to the issue of حكم الاتصال إذا تعصر المعنعن. That Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, he had a condition which was extra, which is ثبوت اللقاء. نعم. And that Imam al-Iraqi, where he said, وَأَوَّلُ مَنْ صَنَّفَ فِي الصَّحِيحِ مُحَمَّدٌ وَخُصَّ بِالتَّرْجِيحِ وَمُسْلِمٌ بَعْدُ وَبَعْضُ غَرْبِ مَعْ أَبِي عَلِيٍّ فَضَّلُوا ذَا لَوْ نَفَعْ. What is it? Being on that particular point, we're going to move on to the second point regarding that same heading, which is, what were the first authentic books that were ever written? We said it's Bukhari and Muslim. We spoke about the first point, which is, who was more authentic amongst them two. And now, inshallah, going to move on to the second part, which is, did Bukhari and Muslim, both of them, did they bring all the authentic books, ahadith that were present in their books? Meaning, all the ahadiths which are in Bukhari and Muslim are the only authentic ahadiths, and anything outside them are not authentic. And that they are the ones that encompassed and have narrated all the authentic ahadiths. Is that the case? The answer is لَمْ يَسْتَوْعِبَا أَمَا لَمْ يَسْتَوْعِبِ الْبُخَارِي وَلَا الْمُسْلِمِ. Bukhari nor Muslim, none of them had brought all the authentic ahadith that were out in the world. They did not bring all of it in their sahih. If you go to Bukhari, rahimahullah, Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, he said, as Ibn Salah mentioned in his kitab Ulum al-Hadith, he said, مَا أَدْخَلْتُ فِي كِتَابِ الْجَامِعِ إِلَّا مَا صَحَ وَتَرَكْتُ مِنَ الصِّحَاحِ لَحَالِ الطُّولِ. نعم. He said, I did not put in my book except that which is authentic. Bukhari saying, I did not put in my book except that which is authentic. And he said, I left a lot of ahadith which are authentic. I left them. Not to lengthen my book. So my book doesn't become too big. So that's why his book was a mukhtasar. He didn't bring every ahadith that were authentic in the world. Same as Imam Muslim. He said, لَيْسَ كُلُّ شَيْءٍ عِنْدِي صَحِيحٌ وَضَعْتُهُ هَا هُنَا إِنَّمَا وَضَعْتُ مَا أَجْمَعُ عَلَيْهِ. Imam Muslim said, not every authentic ahadith, لَيْسَ كُلُّ شَيْءٍ عِنْدِي صَحِيحٌ وَضَعْتُهُ. He said, not everything that is authentic in my eyes did I put in my book. Not every single thing that is authentic did I place in my book. I only put in my book that which is unanimously agreed upon its authenticity. Are you with me? So there are some things that Muslim did see authentic, but he didn't put it in his book. He chose not to. Are you with me? So that question, which is, هَلِ اسْتَوْعَبَا الصَّحِيحِ, did Bukhari and Muslim both encompass, and did they bring all the ahadith which are sahih? The answer is no. But then there comes a question after that, which is, هَلْ فَاتَهُمَا شَيْءٌ كَثِيرٌ, did they, if that's the case then, the ahadith which they have narrated, which are authentic in their books, both of them, is it more than the ones that are remaining? Or are there more remaining out there which they haven't narrated? Which was? This is a question that came up and the ulama of hadith spoke about. Imam al-Hafidh ibn al-Akhrami, and Imam al-Hafidh ibn al-Akhram, rahimahullah, He said, Imam Hafiz ibn al-Akhrami, he said, لَمْ يَفُتْهُمَا إِلَّا الْقَلِيلُ. Nothing has passed them. Meaning what they've left out, both of them, is little. Meaning the hadith that are out there left, which are sahih, are little in number now.